Hello viewers, many of my viewers are asking on one topic, that is how to avoid procrastination or laziness. Very important topic. So on this topic I'm going to speak today. What is this procrastination? Before going to that, I would like to ask you small questions. Do you use words like I'm feeling lazy, I'm feeling bored, I'll not do today, I'll do it tomorrow, not now? This kind of words, are you using it frequently? Then you are going to come under the procrastination category. So procrastination is very bad. It will ruin your life, especially professional life. Your career will be ruined because of procrastination. Never do this. What is this procrastination? Procrastination, I'll give you a good example. So suppose the last week I have completed my thesis, PhD thesis, and submitted. After that, when I came back after submission, I felt like taking a lot of rest, two days at least. I was not feeling like studying, I was not feeling like doing anything, just simply sleeping long hours and listening to any old melodious music, just want to take rest. This is not procrastination. And another example I'll give. Suppose you have a very good task, you wanted to write your GATE or you wanted to write your JEE exam, or otherwise you are submitted very important documents in your organization, or you got a very good achievement, completed the task. Any of such cases also, you feel like taking some rest. That is not procrastination. Procrastination is that when you have the capacity, when you can do the work, but you are delaying it. You have capacity, you have skills, you have ability, but you don't want to do the work. This is called as procrastination. Want to take rest, ignoring the goals, no life at all, nothing, don't want to do anything. This is called as procrastination. That is why never go for such kind of procrastination. I'll tell you today very powerful tips how to overcome this procrastination. The first point is set up your goals. Set up the goals and share your goals with many people. When you have a goal, when you have an ambition, definitely you will not have any procrastination. You don't feel lazy. You have an ambition. Yes, I want to do it. And always that ambition should linger on your mind. It has to remind you all the time. Yes, we have this goal. You have to do that. You have to complete this. So like, keep up the goals. Once if your goal is achieved, then go for next goal. Like, there is unlimited goals in your life. For example, you can take your goals of like your personal life, goals of your professional life, goals of your health, goals of your financial life. Like many goals you can keep and work out on that. You will not find the word of procrastination. And when you have that goal, please discuss with many people. I have this goal, I want to do this, I wanted to go, I'm going to finish this. Then automatically your subconscious mind will make you alert. You will never become lazy. So set up your goals, work out on that. Then you will avoid this procrastination. Second point is stop thinking and just do it. Start thinking and just do it. What you wanted to do, do anything. Suppose I'm feeling lazy, I wanted to get up and I'll do some work. When you start doing any work, automatically you'll become very active and energetic. And don't think for high goals, don't think for high ambition, don't think for overburden or otherwise more goals and more big ambitions. Not required. Small one you start. When you start with small one, automatically you get a kind of encouragement. Yes, I have done this. Then what to do? Self-pat yourself. Three steps of self-pat I told you in the previous video. 1, 2, 3. That's it. Self-pat yourself, celebrate and encourage yourself, recharge yourself, then go ahead. Like this, stop thinking, just do it. And here I wanted to take one quote. This is a quote, very good quote. It's in Urdu. It's like, Kal kare so aaj kar, aaj kare so ab. Pal mein pralay ho jayega, kaam karega kab. It means, whatever you want to do it for tomorrow, do it today. If you want to do it today, do it right now. You know what is going to happen tomorrow. So that is why, never keep any kind of pending work. This is the same attitude I find it in the students, especially when they have to pay the exam fee. In any organization, at the school, college or any other organization, when they have to pay the exam fee, suppose it's June 1st, you got the notice. June 20th is the deadline. Till June 20th, you all will wait. On 20th, entire college will be very heavy rush. All are running and somebody are searching for exam, somebody are searching for challan, going to banks. So this is called as procrastination. When you have a time, complete your work, take rest. feel comfortable. Focus on the other targets. Focus on the other areas. So that is why start doing it. And the third point, what I wanted to say is, always identify some kind of distractions. What is distracting you? What is making you down? So the distractions identify and go ahead. Say for example, social media is distracting me. In social media, WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, internet, Google, all those things, I'm spending a lot of time. If it is useful for your career, you are doing some task, you are working something and you are gaining knowledge, well and good, please go ahead, use it like anything. But you are wasting simply time on chatting and something, just avoid it, cut it. How to avoid it? Suppose daily I am spending my time 1 hour or 2 hours, keep a deadline. I sit only 15 minutes in a day. After 15 minutes, I don't want to watch it. I just wanted to avoid it. I'll focus on my goals. In between, if you get any kind of messages, sounds, or any kind of things, don't distract yourself. I'll see it later. I'm committed. I don't want to distract myself. Like you can control your distractions. Whatever is distracting you, avoid it. In the same friend circle also. There are some friends who comes to you only for time pass. Spending their time and talking nonsense and wasting your mind, energy and all those things. If you find any kind of distractions, do not entertain them. Do not entertain them because you are an ambitious person. You have to do something in your life. So that is why just avoid such kind of people. This is the third point I wanted to say. Next, fourth point is be associated with good people. Avoid the bad company. There is a good saying, tell me your friends, I'll tell your character. It means to whom you are associated is very important. Always be associated with good people who are ambitious and who have knowledge, who are career oriented and who have a very good behavior, character, attitude. To this kind of people, if you are associated, definitely that vibrations, that kind of attitude, that kind of qualities, it will be transformed to you also. That's the reason, have a good association of people. Any kind of bad people are there who are in the negative vibrations, just avoid them. And last fifth point, what I want to say is, listen any kind of good things. Maybe pravachan, or maybe from YouTube you can hear any lecture, or read any stories, good stories, or even from WhatsApp also, if you find any good message which is inspiring you, just listen to that. If you hear more, your subconscious mind will become alert, and you get a lot of vibrations, and you'll become more positive and you'll work out the things, definitely you will be a successful person. If you are coming down also, still it will give you an energy to pull you back side. So that is why hear good lectures and take the content inside. If possible, keep one book, diary, daily note down, whatever you find it. The moment when you find dull, down, immediately open the book, start reading it. That's it. Like this you can go ahead. So these are the 5 powerful tips, my dear friends. Do follow this and let me share some of my experience also. It's regarding this procrastination. Whenever I feel down, I just talk to myself. That is self-talk. I do talk to myself. What I'm doing? Why I'm wasting my time? Okay, 1 day, 2 days. And after that, you have to regain yourself. Talk to yourself. Self-talk. And give suggestions by yourself only. When you can give suggestions? Early morning, 5 o'clock when you wake up, just lay down on the bed and talk to yourself, give suggestions to yourself. In that way, if you talk, if you guide yourself, there is no question of procrastination. Lastly, I wanted to tell you only one powerful mantra. This powerful mantra will make you to outburst this procrastination. So the mantra is that, just think it that it's a matter of. Whatever work you wanted to do, just tell to yourself, it's a matter of 2 minutes. It's a matter of 5 minutes. It's a matter of half an hour. Like this, when you use this word, it's a matter of. You don't feel that laziness. You'll wake up, you'll do the work. So please remember this verb, remember this word and go ahead. And lastly, my dear viewers, my channel has crossed 50,000 subscribers. It's all everything because of you only. It's because of your encouragement, because of your subscribers. And I really thanks a lot. Thanks a ton for all your affection and your words and your encouragement and your comments. Everything is motivating me to do a lot and whatever I can do to the service, to the society. I'm ready to do it. Thanks a lot for your contribution. And do share my videos. Any kind of doubts, please get back to me. I will answer each and every question. Thank you all. Wish you a good luck. Take care. Bye.